And for more on the impact, we're joined by John Quelch. He's Dean of the Herbert Business School at the University of Miami. John, I think Karina did a nice job of setting this up, but I was at an event in 2018 where someone from higher education, an institution all of us are familiar with, was already talking about the alarm bells going off. Foreign exchange students, especially from China, weren't comfortable with the rhetoric here in the United States. They were thinking of going elsewhere. So we're going to see more of these students going elsewhere. What do you think? They're going to stay in China? Would they go to other countries? Where do you suspect they'll go?
Well, Mike, as the dean of a leading business school, I think that business schools are somewhat special in this regard because the United States invented the business school. The bulk of world-class business schools are in the U.S. We at the University of Miami Herbert Business School have seen our applications actually increase this year. We're well known as a China-friendly institution, and Miami, of course, is a very multicultural city. So we're expecting to see a little bit of a problem, but nothing as severe as many other colleges are apparently suffering.
John, you were talking about business. International students are big business. I mean, they're the kind of lifeblood of some of these educational institutions. They bring diversity, of course, but they also bring income. As Karina pointed out, they pay higher tuition fees in many cases. Without them, what kind of economic hit are some of these places of higher education? What are they going to feel? I mean, are there going to be ripples economically?
Definitely. There is no question that the billions of dollars that are represented by Chinese students coming every year into the U.S. higher education system are very, very important to the health of the system. And a dramatic erosion of that would be really quite devastating to a number of colleges and universities that are under-endowed or too heavily dependent upon those students.
John, what about universities themselves? What can they do to cultivate these international students and lure them back if they're starting to think, maybe I don't want to come back to the United States?
Well, you know, what we do, Mike, is three things. First of all, we focus on the program quality. Our very well-known Master of Science in Business Analytics was just ranked number 8 in the world by a very reputable Chinese ranking only yesterday. Secondly, we focus on the project experience, the connectivity to business, which many Chinese students and other international students really look for when they're coming to study in a foreign country. They don't want to be in a classroom alone. They want to be out and about with business people, learning from them in a practical way. So we do that. And then thirdly, very important to Chinese parents is the safety and security of the institution where their children are going to be studying. Even at the graduate level, that's very important. So here in the University of Miami, we have a beautiful self-contained campus in Coral Gables that's close to the city, but not in a downtown environment like many of the urban universities in the big cities of the Northeast and the Midwest.
John, let's say I'm a parent. I have a student who wants to come to the United States and study here, but you know, I'm concerned about the anti-Asian sentiment. I'm concerned about all these gun violence stories, you know, kids being shot at schools, that sort of thing. I'm also concerned about the pandemic and how that was handled. What do you say to those parents? How do you kind of allay those fears that they might have?
Well, at the University of Miami, we're blessed with having as our university president a global public health expert, Dr. Julio Frank, who was formerly the health minister of Mexico. And we have a four-part strategy for ensuring that we can open safely in August. It involves heavy testing of our community members. It involves an aggressive tracing procedure. It involves spatial distancing. And finally, it involves compulsory influenza shots so that people who have the symptoms of fever can be readily identified as not having the flu. So this four-part strategy, we believe, is going to help us open on time in August. But at the same time, we've said to all of our international students through our well-known Flex Arrival program, we're here to welcome you when you're ready to come. We've admitted you. We want you to come. When you feel comfortable coming or are able to get here, we will start your degree program. Of course, if you want to come early and start online, that's fine as well. But many Chinese students who choose to come to the University of Miami, they come here because they want to study in Miami. It's a fascinating multicultural center at the crossroads of Latin America, the Caribbean, and North America, and that's our appeal.
John Quelch joining us from Miami. Thanks so much.